The real number system is an excellent way of depicting all of the real numbers and their positions. So we begin with zero in the middle. To the right, we have the positive numbers. Depicted here, we have the positive whole numbers. And then to the left, we have the negative numbers. And depicted here are the negative whole numbers. If we take all of the negative whole numbers and positive whole numbers together, we get what are called the integers. So again, the integers are both the positive and the negative whole numbers. So they to the right of zero, they're increasing 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. To the left, they're decreasing -1, -2, -3. A very useful way of depicting distance with mathematics is called the absolute value. So with the absolute value of a number, we use the vertical bars here to depict that absolute value. So we would read this the absolute value of -3. And it's a distance, it's the distance of the number from zero on the number line. So -3, which is positioned here, is a distance 3 away from zero, right? So if you imagine starting at -3, you have to go 1, 2, 3 units to get back to zero. Therefore, the distance of -3 from zero is 3, and its absolute value is +3. The absolute value of +3 is also +3 because 3, which is located here, is also 3 units away from zero. If we start at 3, we have to go 1, 2, 3 units to get back to zero. So the absolute value of +3 is also +3. A few other examples. The absolute value of zero is zero because zero is at zero, right? So its distance from itself, of course, is zero. The absolute value of -23, well, if you walk down from zero, 23 units to the left in the negative direction, you'd have to walk 23 units, right? So the absolute value of -23 is +23. Six, well, six is 6 units away from zero, right? So if we start at zero, we have to walk 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units to get to six. Therefore, the absolute value of six is six. Okay, and the absolute value of 817 is 817 again because it's 817 units away from zero. And then finally, the absolute value of -3000. Well, if you walked 3000 units to the left of zero in the negative direction, you would eventually get to -3000. Therefore, its absolute value is +3000. Okay, a couple of example and exercises. To find a number on the number line, imagine starting at zero, and we have a human depicted there at zero. To find -4 on the number line, that negative tells us we're going to go in the to the left in the negative direction. So starting at zero, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 units to the left. So we see the position of four, -4 here. And then the second part of the example says to determine the absolute value of -4. Well, since we have to go 1, 2, 3, 4 units to get to -4, the absolute value of -4 is +4. Couple of example exercises here. Which point represents -2 on this number line? So starting at zero, we're going to go two, but to the left because it's a negative number. So if I go 1, 2 units to the left, I get to B. So B is the point that represents -2 on the number line. Two more questions. What's the value of point A? Well, point A is down here. Notice that's to the left of zero, so it'll be a negative number. How many units to the left of zero is it? Well, we start at zero. So again, imagine you're at zero and you're going to walk 1, 2, 3, 4 units to the left. So we have a -4 there. Point E is here. Point E is to the right of zero, therefore it's going to be a positive number. So we can use a positive symbol. So starting at zero, we're going to have to go 1, 2 units to the right to get to E. And we can leave that as with a plus, I'm sorry, with the positive symbol in front of the two, or we can write it as to without this symbol. Okay, so the positive sign there is optional for positive numbers. The negative sign, though, is required if you have a negative number. Okay, three more. Draw and label the following values on the number line below. Negative 4. So we start at 0. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 units to the left because it's negative. So there's negative 4. Put a dot there for the negative 4. These last two are the first examples we've seen of non-whole numbers, right? So 2.5 means we're going to go 1. We're going to start at 0. We're going to go 1, 2, and then 1 half of a step to the right. So 2.5 is going to be there in between 2 and 3. 0.75 means we're going to start at 0. 0.75 is positive. The positive sign is not written, but it is a positive number there. So we're going to go 0.75 units to the right from 0, giving us the 0.75 like that. Okay, so 0.75 to the right.